It's Reveille in the land of the free and the home of the brave. Memorial Day has come to mean barbecues, ball games, and a three-day weekend. It hasn't always been that way. 3 years after the bloody Civil War that ended slavery, General John A. Logan, a Murphysboro, Illinois native, planned a day that would honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice. Logan selected May 30th. Why that date? General Logan knew that by the end of May, flowers would be in full bloom in every state, Union, and Confederate. Perfect for floral displays in cemeteries. In addition, Logan, wounded in action and national commander of the Grand Army of the Republic, believed the date ideal because it didn't coincide with the anniversary of any battles in the nation's first 90 years. Logan issued General Order No. 11 in early 1868. His goal? To set aside a day for those who answered, in his words, the reveille of freedom to a race in chains. In 1971, Congress legislated Memorial Day to be part of the three-day weekend. No matter, Logan's patriotic holiday has been cherished for over 150 years. In revisionist history books of the 21st century, John Logan has probably been forgotten. Someone in Chicago, however, has not forgotten him. It's Mayor Lori Lightfoot. As part of her efforts at woke government, the embattled executive has placed a statue of Logan on the chopping block. In essence, Lightfoot wants to cancel the man who fought and later memorialized thousands who gave their lives so that all men and women of all colors could be free. For those of you keeping score at home, this is the same politician who's recently gone on record as saying she'd not even allow anyone of Logan's ethnic background to interview her. Of Miss Lightfoot, we can pose what was asked of a politician two generations ago. Have you no shame? A blessed and peaceful Memorial Day to all. I'm Jeannie Ives, co-founder of Breakthrough Ideas. Find out more at breakthrough-ideas.com.